वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट एट्रोफिक राइनाइटिस, आल्सो कॉल्ड एज ओसाइना और ड्राई राइनाइटिस। इट इज़ क्रॉनिक इन्फ्लामेशन ऑफ नोज विद एट्रोफी ऑफ नेजल मिकोजा एंड टर्बिनेट बोन्स। नेजल कैविटी इज रूमी विद फाउल स्मेलिंग क्रस्ट। इट इज़ ऑफ टू टाइप्स, प्राइमरी एंड सेकेंडरी। एंड दिस द सिटी शोज नॉर्मल टर्बिनेट बोन्स ऑन द लेफ्ट एंड एट्रोफी ऑफ टर्बिनेट बोन ऑन द राइट साइड। Primary atrophic rhinitis, its etiology is not exactly known. Theories regarding causation are hereditary factors because it involves more than one member in the same family. Endocrinal basis, as it starts at puberty. Females are more affected than males and it ceases after menopause. Racial factors, that white and yellow races are more susceptible. Nutrition deficiency can be a cause. It can be seen with deficiency of vitamin A, D or iron. Infective agents, like various organisms have been cultured from cases such as Klebsiella oogeni, diphtheroids, Proteus vulgaris, Escherichia coli, Staphylococci and Streptococci. These are secondary invaders which are responsible for foul smelling and not the primary cause of the disease. Autoimmune, as body reacts by destructive process to antigens released from the nasal mucosa. In pathology, ciliated columnar epithelium is replaced by stratified squamous epithelium. There is atrophy of seromucinous glands, venous blood sinusoids and nerve elements, resorption of turbinate bone causing widening of nasal chambers and small paranasal sinuses due to arrested development. Clinical features, it is commonly seen in females. It starts around puberty and there is merciful anosmia, that there is a foul smell from the nose but patient himself is unaware of the smell. Nasal obstruction due to large crusts, epistaxis on removal of crust. Nasal cavity is full of greenish or grayish black crusts covering the turbinate and septum. Roomy nasal cavity with atrophy of turbinate and posterior wall of nasopharynx can be easily seen due to atrophied turbinate bones. Septal perforation and dermatitis of nasal vestibule may be present. Nose may show saddle deformity. Paranasal sinuses are small and underdeveloped with thick walls and they appear opaque on x-ray. Prognosis, disease persists for years but there is tendency to recover spontaneously in the middle age. Treatment, it can be medical or surgical. Medical treatment, complete cure is not yet possible. Treatment aims to maintain nasal hygiene, nasal irrigation and removal of crust. In this, warm normal saline or an alkaline solution is used. Solution runs through one nostril and comes out from other. It loosens the crust and removes thick tenacious discharge. 25% glucose and glycerin, it inhibits the growth of proteolytic organisms which are responsible for foul smell. Local antibiotics, it eliminates secondary infection. Camisetin, anti-angina solution contains chloromycetin, estradiol and vitamin D2. Estradiol spray, it helps to increase vascularity of nasal mucosa and regeneration of seromucinous glands. Placental extract can be used. Systemic streptomycin 1 gram per day for 10 days. Potassium iodide, it liquefies nasal secretion. Then surgical treatment, in this Young's operation, in this both nostrils are closed completely just within vestibule by raising flaps and they are open after 6 months or later. Mucosa reverts back to normal and crusting is reduced. Modified Young's operation, to avoid the discomfort caused by completely closed nostrils, modified Young's operation aims to partially close the nostrils. Narrowing the nasal cavities, it helps to reduce the symptoms and decrease the drying of secretions by air current. Technique used are submucosal injection of Teflon paste, insertion of fat, cartilage, bone or Teflon strips under mucoperiosteum of floor and lateral wall of nose and mucoperichondrium of septum, suction and medial displacement of lateral wall. Secondary atrophic rhinitis, it is secondary to infections like syphilis, lupus, leprosy and rhinoscleroma. These disorders causes a destruction of nasal structures leading to atrophic changes. It can also result from long-standing purulent sinusitis, radiotherapy to nose or excessive surgical removal of turbinate. Unilateral atrophic rhinitis, in cases of extreme deviation of nasal septum, it can be accompanied by atrophic rhinitis on the wider side. Thank you.